You like it? Get out of it.
Remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.
Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. I've got a few things today. I have got a tale of caution and woe. I'm nursing a hangover from the Method of Destruction gig last night at the New Cross Inn. They were superb. Check them out. Yeah, fantastic stuff. And that Billy Milano is a really good front man. And he doesn't like Harry Potter for some reason. I don't know what Harry Potter's done. Anyway, there's going to be a beer review today, and I'm really excited to do this one because it is Beavertown Neck Oil. Now, I've got a couple of things to say about this brewery. I come from the same place as where the brewery is located. I'm from Tottenham. I've lived there. I lived there 45 years. I moved out. I'm in Kent now, obviously. But yeah, Tottenham and Wood Green was my sort of manor, if you like. And as soon as I move out, they start up a brewery, which is probably good because I'd probably spend my time in there. But they do some really funky looking craft beers. And I've heard some really good stuff about the neck oil. Apparently they serve it in the Spurs ground. And I've seen it in petrol stations. I've seen it in Marks and Spencers. In fact, this is where that came from. But let me tell you a little tale of woe that befell me one night. I was looking on eBay, and I always look on, you know, if there's any craft beer or anything like that. And I see Beavertown beers available on there for £1.50 each. And I thought, that is a bargain, £1.50. They're normally sort of double that. They're nearer the £3 mark than they are the £1.50 mark. So I thought, I'll get them. And I bought all six, and they were all different. Beavertown was one. They had the 8-Ball, IPA, Black Betty, Stout, etc. All of them, all for £1.50. And I ordered it, walking around, and I saw all the Beavertown stuff for £2.75, and I thought, nope, I'm not buying that because I'm getting it for £1.50. They turned up the other day. Guess what? They're not cans, they're bloody beer mats. I paid £1.50 for these beer mats, each. Always read the label, that's my motto. But they're nice beer mats anyway, and I'll probably stick them up or give them away in a competition or something. But yeah, they don't taste that great. But there you go, a tale of caution. Anyway, I'm gonna shut up now and get onto this beer. All right, it's the neck oil. Let me just read the spiel on the back. Oh, get the bins on the right way around. It is. It's a 330 milliliter can. It is 4.2% volume of alcohol. They class it as a session IPA. And it's got a really nice can. I don't know if you can see that on the front. But they do these really funky looking cans. Colourful, funky cans. Now, I don't know if they started growing magic mushrooms over Tottenham marshes, but it looks like the person who designed that has done some serious acid or mushrooms or both, probably. Who knows? Right, let's dive in. Let's see what it is. Right, it's an IPA, so I'm assuming there's going to be hops and grapefruit. Let's have a look. Cool. Oh, yes. Very hoppy and nice hops, too. And there's citrus there as well. And it smells really promising. Even Percy's crying, it's so good. Yeah, it's really nice. There's like a grapefruit there, some mango or peach or something like that, and a hoppy overtone, bitter sort of hops overtone. But it's smelly and promising. Let's get it in the glass. There it is, right in the glass. That is a lovely colour. Slightly cloudy, a fair bit of carbonation, one finger head. It's got a yellowy tinge to it. It's not straw. You wouldn't class that as a straw colour. It's just yellow, like a golden yellow. A lot of carbonation in there. I don't know if you can see that or not, but there is loads of bubbles in there. What are we getting? Oh yeah, more of the same. That hoppy grapefruit, citrusy sweetness, and it smells amazing. I'm going to dive in because I really like the smell of this. Wow, that is really nice. I do like this. Now, I thought this was going to be really hop heavy and heavy on the citrus and heavy on the bitterness of it, but this has got a nice sweet balance to it as well, and it's like them that peach and mango sort of flavour. You're getting that in here, but naturally so. It's not like it's artificially flavoured. It's really nice. I can see why they call it a session IPA. Yeah. A beautiful mouthfeel. Really good mouthfeel. Despite the carbonation in that, that has got a really smooth, light mouthfeel. And have you smelt this? I'm not letting you anywhere near this because I know you'll eat it or drink it. Now, right, purse. But yeah, this is a really good one. I'm liking this. Oh, it's beautiful. There's some real hoppy, citrusy, fruity overtones on it, and it's just the balance is just perfect. It really is, and I love it. I think that is superb, and it's got nothing to do with the fact they come from my hometown. They could be anywhere and I would like that. They could come from anywhere and I like that, but that's really nice. That is superb. Beavertown neck oil. If you see this out and about, get it. It's really nice. I would highly recommend this. And I'd give that a 9 out of 10. And the only reason I'd give it a 9 out of 10, that cost me nearly £3. And that is about the going rate for a craft beer. But I think for 330ml, a lot of people are going to look for an alternative. But they shouldn't. You should definitely try it. I really recommend this. This is a great... It's really deceptive. When I opened it, I thought it was just going to be like an overpowering, really hoppy, citrusy, West Coast style IPA, which seems to be the trend now. I mean, everyone's doing it. But this is so drinkable. And I can see why they've started selling this at the Spurs ground. Because it's brilliant. And I think that the fact they've broken in round there, not literally broken in, but they've broken into the market around there, is superb. More people should be drinking this. I think it's that good. And well done to Beavertown for doing that. And it's obviously it's their local team. It's not my team. That was a very unhappy childhood, being a West Ham supporter, being brought up in Tottenham. But I'll leave that story for another time. Anyway, 9 out of 10. Highly recommend it. Get it where you can. Don't be put off by the price. It is worth it, believe me. I would rather pay £3 for a 330ml can of decent beer than £1.50 for a 500ml can of dishwater. But that's just my view. And the reason it's my view is because life is too short to be drinking shitty beer. Like and subscribe. What a puppy gets it. Isn't that right, Purse? Yeah, get off.